I'd slap him around, but he stood at my parents' wedding. Plus, he used to make excuses to get me out of my punishment when I'd slept through head scribe Taggart's lectures. Figure I owe him for that. He means well. I'm not giving up. He wants evidence, but he'll never go looking for it. He's scared I'm right. He'll never listen unless I hold the proof right in front of his face. He's a stubborn old man, but when it comes down to it, he's got our best interests at heart. If he sees some indisputable sign we're on the wrong course, he won't ignore it. That's my question to the Elder. All these years, the Brotherhood has collected weapons technology. And for what? To keep it out of people's hands? That clearly hasn't worked. To defend ourselves? We can't compete with the NCR's numbers or the Legion's. We're fighting a war for a lost cause. If we're going to survive, we have to find a role in society, attract new members. Look at the followers of the Apocalypse. They use their expertise to improve people's lives. They train them to be self-sufficient. That expertise cultivates respect and gratitude, spreads their ideals, draws talent to their cause. They make friends like we make enemies. But they don't know a fraction of what we know. If we took on their role, we could stand up to anyone. We wouldn't have to hide. I don't know. We need something that shows the Brotherhood will fail, or that it can do better a different way. The only thing that gets its attention is technology. Maybe Father Elijah had the right idea. Our elder before McNamara, he had a nose for recovering lost technology. He'd send scribes out into the desert chasing whatever leads he found. There were a few he only trusted me with. I can think of at least one that'd prove my point, if it still exists. There's a comm terminal not too far from here I'd use to access messages from him. If we go there, I can pull up his research on it. I'm with you. Being around here isn't the same anymore. What the fates have in store from their vast mysterious sky. I'll try hard, ignoring what I adore. What is this? Veronica brings an outsider into our home, then has a private audience with the Elder? The two of you may have the Elder fooled, but we know better. Veronica has always twisted the Founder's principles to her own ends. We will not stand idly by and allow her to corrupt our elders' thinking. Some heavenly star spangled
night. We'll find out. Just because I love them doesn't mean some of them aren't assholes. Some's gotta give, some's gotta give, some's gotta give.
It's me again. Mr. Nuvay is reminding you that you're nobody till somebody loves you, and that somebody is me. I love you. If you like news, you're gonna love our next segment. Unconfirmed reports say NCR's General Lee Oliver may have uprooted from his post at Camp McCarran in order to be present at Hoover Dam. NCR sources say that holding the dam against Caesar's Legion has become their main strategic priority, and this move would not be unexpected. Moving on. A hostage crisis between the NCR and the Great Khans was resolved peacefully when a third-party negotiator successfully secured the hostage's release. These headlines were brought to you by Vault 21. Vault 21. Everything's better when you experience it in a vault. Ladies and gentlemen, this next song goes out from me to you.
Let's see what we've got here. Okay, yeah, this is the one I was thinking of. The pulse gun. Although, maybe the rangefinder could work too. And it looks like the NCR was onto some miracle farming technology. Electromagnetic weapon from before the Great War. Experimental. It never saw mass production. But they were building it as a countermeasure to power armor, which they feared the Chinese were developing. Supposedly a prototype was being housed at Nellis. Imagine what it could do to the Brotherhood. We'd be on equal footing with any idiot with a gun. More or less. Supposedly, it's a vegetation enhancer. NCR has a science branch headquartered at McCarran Airport. Guess they found something. Guess somebody wasn't very good at keeping secrets either. We'd never pursue it because it's not a weapon, but self-sufficiency is fundamental to us. If it works, they'd see the value of an alternate course. It's a targeting device for some kind of doomsday weapon based at Helios 1. It was lost sometime after the war. We held Helios 1 for a time. Lost a lot of people defending it. Too many. All for this weapon they never got working. If it turns out to be a dud, it should show how flawed our goals have been. Father Elijah said he thinks a scavenger might have sold it on the Strip. Yeah, maybe they'll think twice about engaging the NCR if they know one of those could be floating around. The notes say to look around Nellis Air Force Base. He suggests going through filing cabinets and computers in the commanding officer's quarters. I like the way you think.
Take care of that robot problem for you. Just saying. Saw you coming a mile away.
Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black. I hugged her and she hugged back. Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in the boat? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. I've sunshine enough to spread. It's just like the fella said. Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in the head? Said, quote, ain't that a hole in the boat? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. She's telling me we'll be wed. She's picked out a king-sized bed. I couldn't feel any better, or I'd be sick. Tell me quick, boy, ain't love a kick. Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in the head.
reminding you that you're nobody till somebody loves you. And that somebody is me. I love you. All the latest news coming your way right now. Good Springs has fended off a mob of escaped convicts after organizing a Boston militia. This according to an old man armed to the teeth with dynamite. In other news, rumors have surfaced that Topps Hotel owner Benny has taken yet another unexpected leave of absence. We spoke to his right-hand man, Swank.
Do I seem worried to you, baby? Sometimes a cat just needs a room to swing. He'll be back. Sure as a conga drum's got a groovy beat.
Today's headlines were brought to you by Prem. Prem, the other New Vegas. In New Vegas, we know the pain that numbers can bring us. Well, so does Guy Mitchell, who's got heartaches by the number.
More buttons and dials and stuff, you know? Oh well, it's still the electronic equivalent of a disease from Gamora.
Thank you.
we're gonna keep you listening all day. Well, you know what that means, folks. Time for some news. The influx of displaced residents to the refugee camp at Bitter Springs has caused a string of rations there. NCR officials are asking for donations. Also, merchants are saying that there's been little contact between traders from Nipton in recent days, causing concerns that the isolated town may be in trouble. Today's headlines were brought to you by...
A few of us wanted to thank you for being such a good friend to the Brotherhood. So we've set aside some of our recycled energy cells. We'll leave a few of them in that footlocker in the corner every so often. The Paladins scoff at using recycled ammo, so no one should mind.
And you meet some nice gals along the way.
Spurs that jingle, jangle, jingle,
jingle, jangle,
as I go riding merrily along. Oh, ain't you glad you're single?
Jingle, jangle,
and that song ain't so very far from wrong.
Jingle,
oh, Lily Bell,
oh, Lily Bell,
oh, Lily Bell,
oh, Lily Bell.
Though I may
Veronica, I hope.
I brought you a present. We found a gun that disables power armor. One of these could defeat the whole Brotherhood. We have to stop limiting our focus to military technology. It won't save us.
That could be the only one of its kind.
That's not the point. Technology won't win our wars. We need numbers, new recruits.
What does the Codex say?
A bunch of close-minded bullshit.
We do not help them or let them in.
But...
We keep knowledge they must never have.
Give it a chance, for me. I can't stay here and watch us waste away.
I'm sorry.
We'll die out.
I know.
Come on. I can't listen to this anymore. He wouldn't listen. The truth was right there staring him in the face. How could he not listen? I see that now. I thought I knew him better than that, but it was like talking to a stranger. How can I help them when they won't accept it? I don't know if I can stay. Maybe it'd be better for everyone if I left. Spent my life somewhere else. Work with the followers of the apocalypse, maybe. Put my knowledge to some good use. Or I can stay here with the people I care about and do whatever I can until it comes to a slow or sudden end. They may be a bunch of wooden conformists, but anything I did without them would feel empty. I'd always be reminded of this day, how I wasn't strong enough to stand by them. So, I guess I'll stay. Won't be easy, but at least I won't feel guilty about the choice. Let's get going. I'd like to get my mind off all this, and some fresh air would do me some good, right about now.
Talking with the Elder. We won't stand for this. Respect nothing. She plants a whisper in his ear, poisoning him against the Codex. No. This has to end now. Execute them.
Ooh.
I should get used to this, I guess. People get desperate. They turn on each other. First thing to go is trust. I don't think it's ever going to be the same for me in there. Knowing no matter what I do, it's going to end badly. But they're all I have. Yeah, I've got the rest of my life to help them out. I could spare a little while to see things through with you. I think so. Two things the Brotherhood has a lot of: hard heads and lasers. Wouldn't be the first time a disagreement ended like this. Plus, we killed all the witnesses. Good idea.